Samsung seems poised to launch the One UI 8.5 beta program for S25 models soon. Initially, it was anticipated that the South Korean company would introduce the beta program in November. However, as the month is nearly over, it appears there may be a delay, possibly due to the postponed debut of the S26 series. The first One UI 8.5 beta software has been detected on Samsung's servers, albeit with a delay. The expected delay for the Galaxy S26 series launch is likely affecting the timing of the beta program as well. It seems unlikely that the beta will be released this month. Nonetheless, the presence of the beta on Samsung's servers suggests that the delay may not be significant, and the company's plans remain largely intact. For context, the initial One UI 7 beta firmware was found approximately 24 days before its public beta release, while One UI 8's firmware appeared on the service 17 days prior to its public beta launch. It is probable that a similar timeline will occur this time around. If that holds true, the first One UI 8.5 beta could be released during the third week of December. We don't yet know how many regions will have access to the One UI 8.5 beta. It's likely that the usual markets where Samsung launches these betas, including the US and South Korea, will be included. Of course, there could always be surprises, but we will find out soon enough. One UI 8.5 is the software update expected to officially launch, not in beta, alongside the S26 trio. Rumors suggest that the South Korean company is working on incorporating Perplexity AI into One UI 8.5, particularly in relation to Samsung's Bixby. It appears the company is considering a significant redesign and enhancement of its digital assistant. Additionally, recent rumors indicate that One UI 8.5 may introduce a new method for managing notifications. Users might be able to assign higher priority to certain notifications. When a notification is deemed important, it would reportedly be moved to the top of the alert list, ensuring it is not missed. If you own a Samsung Galaxy device, you will find various AI assistants available. However, many users prefer Google's Gemini, which is consistently receiving updates and improvements, including the new Gemini 3 model. Despite this, Samsung continues to support its AI assistant, Bixby. Nevertheless, it often feels overshadowed by Gemini and remains relatively overlooked. However, this may change soon. It is anticipated that Samsung has concluded its relationship with Perplexity, and when devices are unveiled, the Galaxy S26 could potentially announce the addition of more AI assistants to its phones. What's more, it may potentially steal technologies from Perplexity and greatly better improve Bixby. This would better compete with Google and demonstrate to users that Bixby is worth paying attention to. It would probably function like this. Bixby would handle simpler user requests, while Perplexity AI would handle more sophisticated ones, generally web browsing. Users would not have to make any decisions about using different models. They would simply work via Bixby. And the theory would probably be similar to when you want to Appleize your Siri and improve it with the help of ChatGPT, but everything will continue to run on its servers, and users would feel like it's simply a smarter Siri. He brought attention to the partnership on the ex-leaker with a nickname Chunlin8888, according to which Samsung already tested Perplexity integration into Bixby, and not only on Samsung Galaxy phones, but also on tablets. Galaxy Tab, something similar, is happening on Samsung televisions, and the South Korean company is already carving its way into the brains of consumers in advance. In the USA, it offers 12 months of free use of Perplexities for Galaxy devices, which may encourage many to continue via Bixby. It is also feasible that Samsung would seek to make further use of AI browser Comet by Perplexity, which is now also available as an application for Android phones. And its connection to Samsung Internet may be worth considering. But we will find out everything explicitly only during Galaxy Unpacked in January or February next year. There's been a lot of discussion regarding the impending S26 series, the phones that are initially supposedly going to rock One UI 8.5. Samsung is believed to have planned some noteworthy improvements to its flagship trio, including perhaps MagSafe-like magnets for actual Qi2 charging support and a boost to wired charging speeds for the S26 Ultra. and there's also apparently going to be a revision in the design of the camera island of the phones. However, there are also likely to be lots of things that are also, well, inherited from the prior generations, including the cameras, potentially. All in all, Samsung looks to have planned some huge things for its forthcoming smartphones, but I'm here waiting for something that would surprise me utterly or get me infused. Strangely enough, a redesigned digital assistant is not exactly making me infused, but maybe that's just because Apple failed to deliver when it said it would with Siri, and my hopes about a smart, context-aware digital assistant have been destroyed. Let's see whether Samsung can change things. Samsung's One UI 8.5 is shaping up to be one of the largest improvements in recent years. The entire UI is likely to get a visual overhaul with better app designs, smoother animations, enhanced blur, and rounded corners across the system. Game Booster is receiving an upgrade on the scale. Samsung is giving it a fresh design, new AI features, and next-level technologies that make gameplay smoother, cleaner, and far more responsive. In One UI 8.5, Samsung is providing a comprehensive visual overhaul to Game Booster. It gets a revamped panel, increased performance modes, greater voice functions, smarter notification controls, enhanced anti-interference tools, and a cleaner touch protection layout. Let's delve deeper so you can easily comprehend what's new and how it upgrades the entire game experience. Refreshed Game Booster UI. One UI 8.5 gives Game Booster a brand new appearance that reflects the rounded corner approach prevalent across the system. The panel seems fresher and more modern. Earlier, you had to exit the game and jump into settings to make adjustments. Now practically everything happens on the fly, without interrupting your gameplay. When Game Booster is fully expanded, you have three modes: Performance, Balanced, and Battery Saver. Each mode alters the color of the panel and has its own set of duties listed underneath it. App shortcuts sit at the bottom so you may switch between apps instantly. Tapping the Advanced Options option lets you select custom FPS, turn frame booster on or off, alter screen resolution, and save your configuration. A pen symbol allows you to change app shortcuts, while the gear icon reveals deeper settings. Samsung has also improved the entire voice system inside Game Booster. Voice Roulette lets you download voice packs and generate instant audio messages using the device's built-in voice generator. You may alter voice tone, direction, and loudness, and even broadcast preset sentences during games. The voice changer now works with Sound Assistant, producing cleaner and more lifelike voice effects. Players can swap between several voice styles in real time. Super Microphone keeps your mic active even if other apps try to control it, and it automatically switches to Bluetooth mix or earbuds to avoid audio conflicts. The anti-interference system with improved gesture control and blocking tools. It avoids accidental status bar pulls, navigation gestures, brightness changes, and Bixby triggers, ensuring better, interruption-free gameplay during full-screen sessions. Touch protection now includes a cleaner layout displaying the time, date, and battery level. Accidental touch rejection has been improved, making it more reliable during intense gaming sessions. Overall, One UI 8.5 is shaping up to be one of Samsung's most substantial improvements in years. While One UI 8 provided only a few apparent changes, this new edition goes far deeper with design enhancements, smoother animations, better customization, and a newly redesigned Game Booster packed with AI features. It actually feels like Samsung is picking up its software game again, similar to what we witnessed with One UI 7. With its projected arrival alongside the S26 series early next year, One UI 8.5 already seems impressive. If Samsung follows through on what we've seen so far, this upgrade may easily become one of the most polished and intriguing One UI versions to date. So that's all we have for now on Samsung's foldable smartphones. Stay tuned to our channel for more updates on this exciting tech. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon to stay notified when we post new videos. Thanks for watching.